Bless God. Amen. Let us praise our God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Jubilee, and I will sign still down.
Hallelujah. Bless God.
Yes.
Bless God.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice. All the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God.
Thank you.
Messiah, Lord of all. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He is the Savior, the one that delivers, the one that rescues, the one that restores. Hallelujah. Salvation has come. Hallelujah. And his name is Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you are in need of being saved, in need of being set free, his name is Jesus. If you are in need of deliverance, if you are in need of hope, his name is Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you're brokenhearted and can't see your way through, his name is Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you're being persecuted, hallelujah. And it seems like it's coming in from every side, deliverance is from Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Jesus, we thank you for the blood that you shed on Calvary's cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Without that, there is no remission of sin. There is no forgiveness of sin without the shedding of blood. And we thank you for shedding your blood. And we say yes to Jesus. Because without him, we cannot get to the Father. There's no other way. There's no other way to get to the Father except through Jesus. So we thank you, Jesus. We thank you. Thank you for giving your life on our behalf. Hallelujah. Opening up the door for us to get to the Father, for us to get to safety, for us to get to deliverance, for us to get to peace, for us to get to joy. It all came through you. Hallelujah. And we thank you. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for your broken body. We love you. Thank you for loving us. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless you, Father.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
We worship you. Thank you, Father. Yes, yes, yes. Glory. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. Bless you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Oh, we praise you, Lord.
Yes, we do.
Thank you for this glorious day. Thank you, Lord, for preparing the way. There's no other day like that day. Thank you, Lord, for preparing yourself, for being the sacrifice, Lord, for laying down your life so we could pick up life in that covenant. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Your word is eternal. Your word has all the power that we need. And as we celebrate Jesus, we celebrate the word. Because it's the word that gives life. It's the word that became flesh. And it's his word in our mouth that destroys the work of the devil. That, Lord, as we commune with you today, Father, that the devil is defeated. He knows it, and the world's going to know it. All those that come in contact with this church, with this people, will know it. That we have a covenant, and we have a cause. And it's because of the cross that we have the victory. Amen. Hallelujah. We thank you for that, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. If our servers will come this morning and serve our elements for us, just take this time as they serve. Just prepare your heart. just to sell out to Jesus. All he's asking is your commitment. That as he lived his life, and he lived a blessed life, don't look to Hollywood to determine how Jesus lived his life. Now, some movies are good, but I tell you what, it don't get no better than the Holy Bible right here, the Holy Scriptures. It paints a picture of truth. And as long as they make a movie that paints that, I'm okay with it. Because we're here to spread truth. Because it's the truth of God's Word that will set people free. It's the truth of the Word. It's how we got born again, that we went from death unto life. And that's what we celebrate, the communion table. It's a celebration of life. From death unto life. And as you prepare this morning, a lot of times I'll pull scriptures from 1 Corinthians or from the Passover. But you know, the Bible says all scripture is given to edify us, to encourage us. All the scriptures are good and profitable. And I just felt like Romans 12, 1 through 2. Because Jesus prepared himself to be a sacrifice. He didn't come down here to do his way, what he wanted to do. He came down here to fulfill all the scriptures. Every I was dotted and every T was crossed. And he finished it on that cross. I said he finished it on the cross. They put a tag up there that says King of the Jews. Rightfully so. He was a king. He still is king. Amen. Hallelujah. Romans 12, Paul encourages here as it says, dear brothers and sisters, this is the NLT, New Living Translations. I plead with you to give your bodies to God because all he has done for you. Let them be a living and a holy sacrifice. The kind that he will find acceptable. Don't look to this world to determine what makes you acceptable to God. You look to Jesus. He's the one that brings us and made us acceptable. This is truly the way to worship him. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, to know that good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. Jesus displayed it to us. Love God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. If you do that, Jesus said, if you do that, you fulfill all the law and all the prophets. And you don't even have to do that. Jesus did it for us. But you do have to do that to prove that you believe. This is how we know that we went from death into life, that we love one another. Even as God so loved the world. Some might say they love you, but do they? Love you unconditionally? That's what Jesus did. Even while I was yet a sinner, Christ died for me. Let his body be broken and bruised so that ours could be made free. So as you take this wafer this morning, know that Jesus paid that price. It was the great exchange that only Jesus could do. His body was blameless. It was perfect. But it had to be sacrificed. It had to be offered up to God. Why? That's the way God set it up. God died for us. Your mind can't comprehend it, but your spirit can. So, Father, we thank you, Lord, for that sacrifice. As we receive this wafer this morning, we receive wholeness in our minds and in our bodies, in our soul. And we thank you for that sacrifice. Receive. And now that same body, blood was shed. The spotless blood of the Lamb. Jackie, will you come up here? Sometimes this little thing here wants to be a problem. I got it. Thank you, Jesus. This blood, Jesus said, this cup, when he took that cup that day with his friends, and one of them was the devil. One of them got possessed by the devil, but he wasn't allowed to partake of this cup. Jesus said, what you do, do quickly, and he left, because the devil has no place in this communion. He has no place. That means he has no place in our lives and in the lives of our children and our children's children. That's a covenant that as we do our part to believe, God does his part to bring it to pass. So, Father, we thank you, Lord, for this sacrifice, for the blood, the new covenant. Jesus, we're going to drink it anew with our Lord and Savior soon and very soon. It ain't going to be long. I said, it's not going to be long.
That's right.
But until then, we're going to occupy.
Amen.
I said, we're going to occupy till he comes. We're going to do the same works that he did and greater works. And Father, we thank you for that covenant. Receive it by faith today and praise him. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Hallelujah. Let's praise him. Let's thank him. We worship you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus.
Turn this thing around, God, turn it around, God, turn it around, God, turn it around. I'm calling on the name that changes everything. God, turn it around, God, turn it around, God, turn it around. All of turn this thing around, God, turn it around, God, turn it around, God, turn it around. I'm calling on the name that changes everything, Lord. God, turn it around, God, turn it around, God, turn it around. All of turn it around, God, turn it around. He is up to something, he is up to something. God is doing something right now, right now. He is up to something, he is up to something. God is doing something right now, right now. He is healing someone, he saving someone. God is doing something right now, right now. He is healing someone, he is saving someone. God is doing something right now, right now. He is moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now, right now. He is moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now, right now. He's moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now, right now. He is moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now. All of my hope is in the name of Jesus. Breakthrough will come, come in the name of Jesus. All of my hope is in the name. God, turn it around. God, turn it around. God, turn it around. Oh, yes. God, turn it around. God, turn it around. God, turn it around.
Hallelujah. Come on, church. How is he going to turn it around? He's going to use you. He's going to use me. See, we're his hands and we're his feet. And thank God for this wonderful song. What it should do, it should encourage us to go out here and lay hands on the sick. That's the way the sick are going to get healed. Jesus is not coming back to this earth yet. He sent the church. God sent the Holy Ghost. And he put the Holy Ghost in vessels that were dirty vessels. But Jesus made them clean. And he who the Son sets free and cleanses is clean. Jesus said, you're clean. My word has washed you and made you clean. See, the devil wants to think you we're not worthy to go out here and do the works. Well, we're not worthy in ourselves, but we're not alone. For God came in. And when he came in, Jesus came in. Life came in. Health came in. That means in his presence, sickness has to leave. Depression has to leave. There's no room for them in the end. So when you make room for Jesus, he clears that stuff out if you'll let him. You gotta empty it into him. You gotta give it to him. See, grace doesn't give you a license to sin. Grace gives you the power to overcome sin. Amen. You're no longer a sinner because of the grace of God has made you free. Amen. Jesus has given us power. There's power in that communion. There's power in that fellowship. There's a communion of the Holy Ghost too. Amen. The Holy Ghost. He makes the difference up. And even Jesus, before he was baptized in the Holy Ghost, said he couldn't do nothing yet because he did it the way God set it up in the beginning. See, we lost it. We lost it through Adam, but we got it back through Jesus. Amen. The devil, he's defeated. I said, he's defeated. Hallelujah. Jesus confronted the devil. And the devil is in, he was in people and he's still working through people today. So don't, you know, this big thing today is, you know, we shouldn't offend people. Well, you know, the evil offends me. The Bible says to hate evil. Don't let your son go down. And give no place to the devil. Don't give him no place. We've given him too much space. And it's time to put him in his place. He's not looking at your face and you shouldn't eyeball the devil. He's under your feet. Don't talk to him. Don't have conversations with him. Put him in his place under your feet. Amen. We got power. We got authority. In his name. And you know what? The next best thing we're getting ready to do, we're getting ready to knock him down. When we give to the work of the Lord, it drives the devil another inch down in the dirt, in the dust. Why? There's inflation. There's chaos all around. But we're not in that camp. Once you get born again, we've been delivered out of that curse, and we've been placed in the blessing. I said, we've been placed in the blessing has been placed in us. In us. Christ in us. The blessing's in us. That means where we go, we bring the blessing. The earth is still cursed, but we bring blessing to it. Can Israel, can that wilderness, can that desert, can it bloom again? Yes, it can. Yes, it has. In 1948, it became a nation again. May the 14th, that was my birthday. Now, I wasn't born yet, but that was the day I was coming in 1966. And we support Israel, CUFI, Christians United for Israel. We're partners with that organization, with John Hagee, Pastor John Hagee. See, if God don't raise people up, it ain't going to get done. But then he's raised some people up, and they're not doing nothing. We ain't that bunch. We're going to be the ones that do something. Amen. And as you get ready to give this morning, know you're doing something. I got a letter Mercury One sent us a report this morning. One of our partners, Glenn Beck, is the founder of Mercury One. And he just briefly here, it says, "Dear friends, all I can humbly say is wow. 2023 has already been a pivotal and triumphant year for Mercury One because of your generosity. It is my goal to bring hope back to our nation, to restore the human spirit and preserve our nation's heritage so we never forget where we came from and where we want to go. Through your support, we have rebuilt communities after devastating tornadoes, saved lives in Turkey after historic earthquakes, and shared the true story of our nation with over 12,000 individuals this summer." Glenn says, "As I reflect on this year so far, I'm grateful for God's guidance and your immense kindness and sacrifice. May God bless you." Glenn Beck. That's just one of our partners that we're touching lives and changing people's lives. All it takes is a dollar. You know, we had a wonderful time with Pastor Scott and Shirlene Gray at Hope Church as they dedicated their sanctuary. It's just been something they've been wanting to do. It got passed on and passed on with their upgrades. And Karen and Derry Jolly, that are ambassadors to nations through Freedom Christian Center of Charlotte, called to Nicaragua doing her work in missions. She shared her heart, and just what was it? 32 cents a day, I believe. $10 a month. The Lord told them, if you get people just to give $10 a month, that's what, $120 a year? They're changing the nation for God. And a lot of other ministries have went up. They said $30 to $40 a month. She said, we didn't. We didn't go up because that's what God said to give. Some have gave 10 and some have gave more than 10. And we'll get them here at this church and have them share what God has done over the last 20-some years in their team. And it all started when God spoke to her heart when she went on a missions trip. All it takes is somebody to hear his word. To hear and obey. Amen. Be obedient to that voice. That's all God's asking you to do today. Every day, every week, is set aside something as your purpose in your heart to give to the kingdom. And when it comes in this church, it goes for missions. We give at least, as long as I can remember, at least 13 to 17%. Tithe is 10%. We tithe as a church. We do over tithe. My goal is to double it, because if the law says 10, I like to do at least double it. Amen. And God gave the law for principle. But he says, as your purpose in your heart, give. So as you get ready to give this morning, the Bible says in Psalms 37, 23, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. Let me just read a few more. Though he fall, he shall not utterly be cast down. Well, don't even focus on the fall. Don't even focus on falling, because the Lord is your shepherd. Amen. If we're following, I don't remember Jesus stumbling around in the dark. So if we're following, if we're walking with Jesus, we don't have to focus on stumbling. He just said, if you stumble. David said, I've been young and now I'm old. And he ain't old no more. He's with Jesus. He's in heaven. But down here, we're getting older. But in the inward man, I'm getting newer. I'm getting strong day by day in my spirit, man. David said, I have been young and old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken. Never. Nor God's seed out begging for bread. God is ever merciful, and he lends, and his seed is blessed. You know, Jackie just shared with me this morning, her daughter got robbed this past week. Went to the bank, was getting some money, was counting it, and the individuals came, opened up her door, grabbed a gun out of her car, took her money. Thank God she's alive, but robbed her in daylight, broad daylight, at gunpoint. But God, see, Jackie's got a covenant. That's her seed. That's her daughter. God, she didn't get shot. She didn't get killed. The thieves even got caught. Got her money back, but you know what? We ain't done yet. In the name of Jesus, the thief's got to pay her sevenfold restitution for what he tried to do. I said, for what he tried to do. See, we got a covenant with God. And we're sticking it to the devil right now in the name of Jesus. And we pray for the salvation of those individuals. One thing you pray, when that happens, pray they get in jail, find Jesus in jail. They need to be locked up. They don't need to be patted on the hand, say, don't do it again. They need to be locked up. And they need to repent. They need to find God. That's the only way true people are going to change. It's when they find God and they let Him come in. David said, is there not a cause? Depart from evil and do good and dwell forevermore. For the Lord loves judgment. He loves righteousness. And He forsakes not His saints. We are preserved. There it is, Jackie. We are preserved forever. Our seed, but the seed of the wicked, they'll be cut off. If those individuals don't repent, one day they'll be cut off from the land of the living and they'll go in hell without Jesus forever, tormented. But that's their choice. They don't have to go there. They don't have to be out robbing people. The Bible says once a thief's caught, they need to get saved, they need to get born again, and then go work and repay with what you did wrong, make it right. Go work with your hands. A thief is going to be a thief until that thief gets born again. That's his nature. It's called sin. But Jesus took care of the sin.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
He took care of it. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell therein forever. I'm saying that to tell you, don't get in fear. See, what's our theme this year? Fear not, for the Lord is with thee. God was with Amanda. There was angels there. God's covenant's there. But we can take it to another level. Amen. So, Father, we thank You right now as we give this morning. We thank You, Father God, that You have already met all of our needs according to Your riches and glory. And as we bring our tithes and offerings and worship You this morning, we thank You that we have a covenant promises that You rebuke the devourer, the seed eater, the one that's trying to devour our children, devour our seed. Lord, You raise up a standard against them. Lord, You have angels encamped about, and them angels can bring judgment if need be. To preserve Your covenant, preserve Your children, to preserve life here on this earth. But Lord, we're not the judge. You are the judge. We're to love, but Lord, we also have a covenant. And David said, there's a cause. Is there not a cause to stand up against evil? And sometimes you just got to destroy evil. I said, you've got to destroy evil, either by the word or by the sword. Father, we thank You as we bring our tithes and offerings, Lord, that You cause a hundredfold return in our lives now. Right now. In Jesus' name. Can you say amen? Come worship the Lord with your tithes and offerings. Bless you, Father. Are ordered of the Lord.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank You, Lord, for this day. I didn't come purposely dressed as a pumpkin today, really. That's what He told me. We have a song we'd like to sing for you. I think it's a song anointed by God. It's one that became new to me just a couple months ago, a few months ago. I've had it and didn't even realize it in my catalog. But I was going through things, and this just came out at me. And I asked Wayne again if he'd sing with me, and graciously again he accepted. So I pray it be a blessing for all here. Thank You, Lord.
Yes, you are Lord. An on-time song for an on-time God. Lord, Father, we thank you, Lord, that this offering is holy unto you. Lord, it's not the money that's precious, it's your people. I said, Father, it's your people. Whether you're a singer, whether you're whether you park people in the parking lot, whether you greet people at the door, you are a precious people because we're God's people. I said, we're God's people. All people are precious in His sight. Some just not have gave their life to the Lord. And what tears is, you know, the biggest tear that God's going to have to wipe away is His tear. His tear. When Jesus is going to have to say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. There's going to be, Jesus is going to have tears. That He's going to have to send them to an everlasting damnation. Not because of God's choice, their choice. It's our choice. To serve God or not. Moses told a people that rebelled against him. They couldn't see Moses as God. Moses was not God, but he was God to the people. You know, my pastor was God to me. Underneath his teaching, he was speaking. Randy, you know how I fought? You know how we came to Concord? Because me and Sherri, we just shared this with a couple. A wedding I performed for a couple right across the street. Closest wedding I ever done. 15 minutes. I got ready. I went. My neighbor. But sharing them about where to go to church and how to be where you're supposed to be, me and Sherri said, we heard our pastor on the radio. I forget what channel it was. We was seeking God in all places we could find him. We heard Andrew Womack. Jim was either before Andrew or after him. And then Brother Bob Cohan. There was three in a row. Pastor Bob Cohan. He's in heaven now. They were all saying the same thing. The blood of Jesus, the word and faith. Grace and faith. And the blood, Bob Cohan, he was powerful in that blood. You mentioned the blood around Pastor Bob. It was on, brother. But we told him, you know where God, where you're supposed to be? Me and my wife, we had problems, man. We needed help. People need help. We didn't know this great God that we hadn't served for so many years. And we needed help, so we... God sent us to Concord. Yeah. My wife kept asking me, where are we going to go? Because we was indecisions. What are we going to do? You know, it's kind of like the pressure was on, but the Word of God, the Holy Ghost said, I said, I know what we're going to do. We're going to go to Concord, and we're going to get underneath the Jim Howard. We're going to submit underneath the pastor, and we're going to learn. Amen. And that's where we went. Because we would go there on Wednesday nights having problems. We already decided we're going to go up there and we're going to ask for prayer. And he would, Judy, the message came. There was hardly any times that we had to go up for personal prayer, because if you'll listen, if you'll pull it out, God will give it to you right out of it. He was God to me. He spoke to me. He spoke to us. And we're like, we looked at each other and like, that's God. Answered prayer. That's where you go to church. That's where you plug in. Amen. That's where we plugged in. And we ain't unplugged since. I told Jim I'm here to serve him until he's one of those was nots like Enoch. He just was and was not. Whether it's by the rapture or Jim goes, he'll be walking and talking. Next thing you know, he'll be in heaven with Jesus. For Enoch had this testimony. He pleased God. Amen. My pastor has pleased God because he preaches and teaches faith. And he serves God with all that he knows how, with all the revelation he knew how. He served him faithfully. There's a lot of times he didn't know why things were happening in his life or in his wife's life. But you know what? God was faithful. Yes. And he saw him through. And he'll do the same thing for you. He's done the same thing for me. If you'll just trust him. Amen? Amen. Trust him. Sing a song as the Lord presses in your heart to bless somebody. Amen? David was a psalmist. He was anointed to be king. David was anointed to be king by Samuel. But he wasn't king yet. He wasn't in the office yet. And the king, Saul, was trying to kill him because of the devil. See, the anointed had left Saul because of disobedience. Saul tried to do something that God said, you ain't going to do that. You let the priest do that. And Saul got caught up in pride. And what? A fall. That's what happens when you get caught up in pride. If you don't turn and repent, you'll fall. And that anointing was taken from him. It was torn from him and given to another, King David. But David, Saul tried to kill him. David being there playing his harp, playing, ministering because of that evil spirit. David was trying to drive it out, and Saul throwing spears at him. I tell you what, David had a covenant, and he knew, touch not my anointed and do my prayer. David would not touch king. He would not speak a word against his king. Amen. He said, it's up to God. God, it's up to God. You, if you anointed me at the appointed time, you will set me in that office. And he did. But God is merciful. I said, he's merciful. It's not for us to sit in that judgment seat. Not yet. The Bible says we will sit and we will judge angels. But not yet. Not yet. But we are to occupy and destroy principalities and powers and put the devil under our feet. Keep him there. Amen. Keep him there. So today, if you're joining us, this is part four on God wants his people to be healthy. Now, we started this a couple months ago. The Lord dropped in my heart that God wants his people healthy, wealthy, full of the Holy Ghost and power. That's where it started in the garden. God's people, God's children had that. Adam and Eve had that. Amen. There was still work to do. You didn't have to toil for it, toil. You didn't have to sweat for it. Sweat's under the curse. It was just trusting God. God wasn't feeding them the fruit off the trees. They had to go pick it. Amen. Had to go what? Harvest what God had given them. Amen. And plant. He gave them a garden. But you know what? He's there with them, teaching them. So God, through Jesus, brought us the greatest teacher, himself. Man messed it up, but God says, I got to go down there and fix it. He looked at the Father, and you know, they made this plan before he even created mankind. They're going to mess it up, but we're going to go down there and fix it for them. Amen. Thank God. God's good at fixing things. Amen. So as the Lord dropped it in my spirit, Let me tell you, folks, we're in the end times. We're in the latter. The clock is ticking. My assignment to God and to this church is to keep fear out of you. My assignment is to teach and preach the word of faith to you and to the world. And we're in the days that fear, the Bible says in the end times, that for the fear that's going to come upon men, their hearts will even fail. People are going to start having more stress and heart attacks and depression and all this stuff. Now, I'm talking about people that don't have a covenant, or some people that have a covenant and don't know what's in the covenant.
Amen. Amen.
There's Christians out here that don't have to be in the shape they're in. But they got to determine, they got to find out this covenant they got. They got to quit relying on the pastor and get in that book for themselves.
Right.
Now, I'm not saying that because I'm a pastor. I'm saying that because I don't go home with you, but the Holy Ghost does. Amen.
Amen.
And he's your best teacher. He's your teacher.
Yes.
He's there to bring back to your remembrance what you heard me say. And don't you listen to it unless he said it too. Because sometimes I might say some things that might not be quite Holy Ghost, but I am not just the Holy Ghost. He's one third of me, but I do have a soul, and God will inspire his word through me. I'm different than Tammy or Wayne or Terry, but the word is the same.
Amen.
Amen. And that's where my wife... When we took the kids out for the, what was the name of that thing, Reed? We just took them out and had putt-putt, and it was just a kid that, we don't have to have a title on everything. What was it? Yeah, we went down to the, yeah. We just got the kids, we said, we're going to do something. We're going to get together. We went out, we took them, gave them ice cream, food, played putt-putt. Thank God I was off, because I enjoyed myself. But we're teaching them and showing them Christ. And there's no fear. And we just heard some things that's happening out here. Women, I'm telling you, just God didn't say shut your eyes. Brother Hagin was good about watch and pray. Keep your eyes open and pray. If you see me praying with my eyes open, because sometimes I'm watching who or not's coming in the house. Amen. And we got eyes other than me watching people watching these doors. Why? Because the devil is out to steal, kill, and destroy. See, we got a spirit, but God also gave us a brain. So women, God sees you as the weaker vessel. That's just the way he says. So men sometimes see women as weaker vessels to rob them and steal them and rape them and all these things. But that's not God's will. So women, be watchful. The Bible says, go out two by two, preach the gospel. I wouldn't go out alone these days. I would go with somebody. That's just good sense. If you're a lady, if you're a woman, if you're going to go to the store, take your child or take somebody with you. Why? Because it's the days we're living in. But don't be in fear. Jesus is always with you. But you got to know he is and know that there's power in his name. And you can speak to that person in the name of Jesus and you can tell them to fall to the ground. That's the authority you carry. And there's an angel there to make sure it happens. I've heard many ministers talking about people coming down and coming into services, trying to shoot Oral Roberts and kill him. Bullets and John Hagee, that's how his ministry started. A guy shot at him point blank. Bullet never hit him. Miracle. I'm sorry, it might have hit him. I can't remember that. But it started because of somebody tried to come in there and kill him. That guy got knocked down or got prayed for. He got saved. He got born again. You can't curse what God's blessed. Amen. And don't. There's some crazy people in the world, but I tell you what. Touch not my anointed, the Bible says. Do my prophets no harm. You're God's anointed. Once you get born again, it ain't just a five-fold ministry, the prophet, pastor, evangelist, teacher. It's you. Amen. God's people. So, but anyway, that's why the Lord dropped this in my spirit about your finances, your health. My gosh, people, we used to be a nation that made steel and made things and built things. Now we're sending it overseas. You know what the biggest thing in this nation is? Pharmaceuticals. Pharma. Big pharma. They want us sick, they want us poor, and they want the power. I'm talking about the devil using people. Now, I'm not speaking against our authorities. I'm speaking of one that has authority. God, amen, through his people. And we're not going under, we're going over. Yes. Amen. I'm talking about the church. Yes. So is the church, so goes the nation. And too far, that the temperature of the church has been is looking around at our nation. Amen. So we're going to do our part. We're going to boldly declare the word of the Lord. Amen. And stand up against evil and put it in its place. Amen. Because darkness has no place with light. It has no fellowship. Amen. And the main thing the devil's going to try to do in these end times is bring division in the church among his people. Because he knows on the day of Pentecost, 3,000 people in one message got born again. That's defeating the kingdom of darkness. That's when the power's there. Amen. When the Holy Ghost is speaking and the gifts are flowing and people getting healed, delivered, and set free. Then we destroy in darkness. Amen. We gain in ground. See, it's past time just come in here and make you feel good. It's time for you to be good. Amen. Be good. Do good. Do good to evil. Amen. Hallelujah. So we're gonna be focusing on your health. Now, I'm not up here, I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but we've learned some things over the last 3 years in this nation that there's some people out there that just want to control us. He's the devil, and he's using people. This church will be open until Jesus closes it. Amen. Until Jesus closes it. And we have the right as people, as children of God, to go where we want to go and do what we want to do as a free people. Nobody should tell us what to eat, what to put in our bodies. And I'm telling you, the devil wants to destroy. He wants to steal, kill, and destroy. So that's why we got to preach about being healthy. God wants us healthy and wealthy, and it's through his word, through his covenant. Amen? That when God brought them out of Egypt, Pharaoh was destroying God's covenant people. He was using them as slaves to build his kingdom. What do you think the devil's trying to do? To build darkness. He wants to use God's people. It ain't going to happen. Amen. Because Jesus has set us free. When God set Moses, when Moses got God's people out of Egypt, the next thing he had to do was try to get Egypt out of the people. See, we got to keep, fear has no place in God's people. And when you see fear being pushed, this is me personally. I quit watching TV, mainstream TV, years before COVID, years ago. Because you couldn't watch a program without getting 15 minutes of advertisement. And most of it is prostrate. You know what I mean? All these, they won't tell you, are you above the age 55? Is your blood pressure high? All these things they want you to start believing for. Start expecting. Well, I found out that's not in my covenant. Amen. That's not in my covenant. And see, what they're selling you something. They're selling you fear. Because if fear can get in, that's what's coming through fear. And just think about this. You know, I'm a techie guy. Now, we're talking about to hear and be healed. Well, you can hear and be free. Free from, the Bible says to be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. See, we're not to close our eyes to things that are not right. Because if we do, we're losing ground. But we still watch things, but it's wholesome things. Years ago, there was a lot of wholesome things that you could watch. Not so much today. We don't pump mainstream cable, and we use a live, our internet connection, and we watch what we want to watch. We make the choice. Because when you, and this is just it, if you buy certain cable channels, they gave you a basic plan. Now, you got a choice to cut off, cut on, but they're pumping that into your house. And a lot of the stuff, it just ain't worth it. If you want peace in your home, don't bring the world in there. Amen. Cut it off. Don't listen to it, because words are coming in. And words are getting in your spirit. They're getting in your soul, man. Not now, you're born again. The Holy Ghost, you're sealed, but your soul, man, your emotional realm, words still affect that. Amen? You might say they ain't, but it is. Because Jesus said, be swift to hear, slow to speak. Because with what you're hearing, you're going to give attention to it. Amen? Because words have power. So I'm just telling you, the Lord wants us to know His covenant. Just like Moses brought the people out, they brought the spoils with them, the gold and the silver. God don't have a problem with everybody having stuff, but not to abuse people with it and to use people and to manipulate and to control. See, deception in these last days, deception's out there, lies, all kind of lies and deceptions. That's not God. I said, that's not God. So don't give that. I trust, we got to put our total trust in God. Amen. And if you'll put your trust there, the Holy Ghost will show you things. That I prayed this morning for a GE technician. He's a pastor too of a church of God. He's in Charlotte somewhere. He's been with the company, gosh, he's about probably close to retire, 30 plus years, and he's in the church of God. And I specifically had a dream about him this morning just to pray for him. And I sent him a text, because being a pastor in the fivefold ministry in these end times, we're in areas we've never been before, and we need each other. And I just know the Holy Ghost had me to pray just to encourage him that it's your appointed time is now. What God's called you to do, you're going to do it. He's heard your prayers, and you're going to fulfill it. See, we need to encourage one another. And the Holy Ghost is going to show us things to come before they come. That's prophecy. Amen. Words of prophecy, dreams and visions. That's how God protected Jesus. Through Joseph, gave him a dream. This is God's son, but God still had to use this world system that he created, that he set up, that man messed it up. But God sent us the Holy Ghost. Amen. His spirit has still been on this earth. He hasn't left this earth yet. We leave, but Holy Ghost is still going to be here, but he's in us. Amen? And there's coming dark times, and the Lord wants us to be prepared, to be ready. He showed me this morning, and when he showed me, I just heard it. People people are going to be running in the spirit. I said this at Hope Church. There's coming a time people are going to be, God just showed me, they're running in the spirit. They're going to be coming to this church. Not just this church, but churches that have power, churches that are fixing things and helping people and bringing life and not fear, operating in faith and not fear. People are going to be running into here, and we got to be ready for them to take them in and disciple them for a short work that the Lord's going to do in this earth. Things are increasing. Amen. And what God has got to get done, it's going to take a short time and a short work. And he's going to use us, amen, if we'll be willing and obedient and be there. Amen. He needs an army that's not like David, not like Saul. Here, put my armor on and go fight the devil. No, we need his armor, God's armor. And have it on 24/7. And be ready in the midnight hour to get up and pray, and pray in the Holy Ghost. Until you get a release, get a peace in your spirit. You don't know who you're praying for, but you're praying for somebody that God needs, and that the devil might be trying to kill them. That God needs them saved. Amen. God needs them protected, like Amanda. Amen. So you need the power. If you're not filled with the Holy Ghost and speaking tongues, you need to be operating in that gift. And we're here to encourage you to receive that gift. If you've received the Holy Ghost, He is the giver of the gift. And it's in him, but he's got to use your tongue in cooperation. And you have that prayer language. Amen. To where my God at night, me and my wife was first learning about the Holy Ghost and power. And I received my prayer language, received that power and prayed and started operating in the Holy Ghost, praying in my most holy faith. My gosh, I remember one night, Jackie, there was I can't prove it in the flesh, but I can prove it in the spirit. We got a deck on our back porch, and it come in our bedroom window. When I extended the deck, it brought the floor right up to that window, our window. And we don't lay down at night in fear. Our windows are locked, but it don't matter if I left it locked or unlocked. I'm not in fear about it. But my wife can attest, when I sleep pretty good. Maybe not like Rowan, not as sound as he does. But next thing I know, there's tongues of men and tongues of angels. It was a different tongue that night. And Sherri, she's more of a light sleeper. She said she heard something by that window on the deck, heard a noise. And immediately she heard me going praying in the Holy Ghost. And it wasn't, hallelujah, conda da si, hallelujah, conda da si. Now, it was loud enough that whoever was trying to come in the window heard and seen. Tessa's is talking about hear and be healed. I'm sure they heard and saw something. Probably my big angel that's all around camped about me and my family. And that person never came in that window. That's because the Lord has a covenant. And he'll if you're in agreement with the Holy Ghost, he'll speak through you. Amen. You won't have to think about what you're going to do. You'll know what to do when the time comes. Amen. You'll know. You know, 9/11 is right coming down the road. And there's evil people out there that would just like to duplicate and do something evil. They're already doing it around the world. My gosh, our neighbor last night had a big bonfire. She's burning some stuff. I'm in Rowan's room in the back room right here by the fence. I'm getting prepared for the day. Sherri's sitting there talking to me, and she's at a place where she's seeing out the neighbors getting ready to burn some pallets and all kind of stuff. I didn't see this, but she had gas on the fire, but undoubtedly it wasn't lightened. So she has the gas can, and Sherri's telling me this. Next thing I know, boom, and it shook. I'm like, what in the world? Sherri goes, oh, gosh, she's okay. I'm glad she's okay. You don't throw a fire can around a fire, and it exploded. And thankfully, everybody was okay. Why? There's angels out there. My angels are out there protecting people that don't even know they got a covenant with God. People doing stupid stuff. Why? I just believe that. God's merciful. Her kids were out there. Chickens were out there. Cats and dogs were around that fire. But God was around the fire. Amen. He's a consuming fire. But I thought about that this morning. I said, my God, think about people that live in Israel, Pakistan, Ukraine, these bombs. That was just a fire. Bombs exploding, ground shaking. Can you imagine the fear that they're in? When all the time we got a covenant with God, that we got to preach and teach this word of faith to the world to get people prepared. And it's not God's will that these people, that any people perish and die through all these wars. But the devil don't like people. He hates people. And until Jesus comes and destroys him, we got to occupy. And one thing we got to be in these last days is we got to be strong in our finances, be strong in the word of God concerning our healing, our health, and be strong in the power. Amen. Amen. To be able to release that power at any time that whatever God needs us to do. Amen. Holy Ghost power. I just felt like this morning I might grab that mic. I felt like maybe the R.W. Shambach anointing might hit me this morning. Y'all, anybody remember R.W. Shambach? You ain't got no problems, my brother. All you need is faith in God. He lived that, preached that, left this earth shouting it, amen? And he had problems, Randy. The devil gave him problems preaching the gospel. We'd get him locked up, put in prison. But the Holy Ghost, good old story, the Holy Ghost got him locked up. I mean, the Holy Ghost got him unlocked. Got him put in prison. People, you know, because he'd set up tents, 10,000 of big tents, preaching to go to the inner city. Go to the drug addict side. Go to the poor. Go to those that can't help you, but God, we can help them. Amen. He'd go set that tent up, but they didn't want him to come. Devil didn't want him there. And he'd use people, and they had him locked up. They said, if you come here and you get on that stage, because somehow he didn't have the permits or they were doing something, he said, we'll get you locked up, preacher. He didn't care what they said. He got up on that stage, but they come, they put him in cuffs, put him in jail, but God was with him. I maybe told this story before. Got him in jail, but the Holy Ghost gave him a vision, gave him a word. So one of his workers came to him, his assistants, Brother Shambach, said, go get me a Catholic priest robe. Bring it to my jail cell. The one that has the white. put that thing on when it comes time. Now, remember now, the tent's still set up. So I guess he had an early, had to prepare before the judge early. They bring him into court. There's Brother Shambach in the Catholic priest robe, and the judge is up there. And he pretty much says, what's he here for? For preaching the gospel? We got him, whatever they said. Well, the judge is Catholic. I don't remember exactly what was said, but pretty much said, Father, he looks at this priest, Father, this is just a bunch of lies and stuff. Let this man go and get him back out there on that stage. Just pretty much got him free. Went back and preached that gospel. Because the Holy Ghost said, get me a Catholic robe. Because God knew the judge was Catholic. And he said, ain't no father, I ain't putting no father behind the bars for preaching the gospel. Ain't going to happen. See, that's the kind of judges we need. But more than that, we need to hear, what has the Holy Ghost said? You know, they put Peter in prison. For what? Preaching the gospel, the good news. But what? God sent his angel. Why? The church was praying. See, God first, how can we get anything done on earth except first God's people pray? So the church is over here praying, and God sends the angel. Poked him. Peter was sleeping good. Why? He'd been in storms with Jesus. He said, I'm going to do what Jesus, I'm going to sleep. Remember, he's sleeping in the storm. Peter, Lord, Lord. Peter done got that Holy Ghost. Got that Holy Ghost anointing to go to sleep. Amen. Either I'm going to go to heaven and see Jesus, but I'm going to sleep right now. Had that anointing, that Jesus anointing sleep. And the angel has to kick him. Wake up, Peter. Get up. See, the angel can't pick him up. He got to walk out. See, you got to get up, man. You got to walk. The angel ain't going to do the work. He ain't going to preach the gospel. That's what Peter had to do. But the angel's job is to come for the word. They done prayed the word to get Peter out of jail. Get up. Break the chains. Open the jail door. Same way they got Jesus out of the tomb, got Peter out of jail. Amen. Angel rolled that stone away. Can't no grave hold our Lord. Amen. Well, can't no prison hold you. Amen. Can't no school board keep you from going there and preaching truth about my kids going to school to get education. And he's going a boy and he's leaving a boy. She's going a girl and she's leaving a girl. Shouldn't be no teaching. Bring confusion in there. God made them male and female. That's truth. My God, that's common sense. I went to school and they were teaching good things, and it was my stupidity. I didn't learn nothing. We need to at least make sure our kids can be taught, have stuff in there that's right. That back then in my day, they were taking the Bible out. I didn't know all that stuff. Somebody just needed to preach the gospel and get Jesus in me. Amen. I can remember right now, Terry, I was a sophomore in high school. My sister could tell me the guy's name, but I can remember this guy. If I'm sitting here today, I'd watch him. He'd come down to smoking. Back then, we had the smoking area. You had to smoke outside by the lunchroom. I'd see him coming down the steps. He had a Bible in his hand. He walked in. He had purpose. See, we're getting ready to talk about plans, purpose, and pursuit. I looked at him, and I was like, man, that's a Jesus freak. Look at him, man. Got the Bible in his hand. I called him a Jesus freak. I saw life in that person. Yeah, he was a Jesus freak. He knew in whom he believed. Carried his Bible in school. Lived it. Loved it. I could see it in him. That's me now. Amen. That's me now, Randy. I wish somebody would have told me about that Jesus. And they probably did. I probably just didn't listen. But I tell you what, I got an experience. He's real. I said, he's real. God is real. He goes past the pages. And he came into my life. Amen. And he fixed my life. Now, he said, now you got to keep it fixed. Amen. When you get healed, you got to stay healed. Amen. Buck, you've got that healing, but you got to keep it because the devil wants to try to come back and attack you. But if you get in that covenant and know who you are, you'll be praying in the midnight hour. Holy Ghost come upon you. That flu season, ain't no flu season. You can call it COVID-19, COVID-20, COVID-23. I call it Psalms 91. No plague shall come near my dwelling. Amen. Nor my children's children. You know, Rowan was down there at the baseball, down there at college. You know, that, what was the name of that hurricane? Audia. Idalia. It's not like a Vidalia onion. Audalia. Well, I tell you what, Rowan, they took pictures, man. They out there going to practice field in about a foot of water. But you know what? I wasn't in fear. Neither was he. God is with thee. Yea, though I'm walking through a foot of water, my God is with me. Amen. Don't ever flood the earth. It might be look like it's flooding, but it ain't covering the whole earth because God said, I'll never flood this earth again. See, I know the covenant. We know the covenant. Fire's coming, but guess what? I serve a God of fire. Amen. I ain't going. I ain't being burned up. I'm already consumed with his glory. Amen. I don't care how hot things get. Can't touch me. Amen. Because Jesus is in the fire with me. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to spread some fire. Amen. We're going to spread the Holy Ghost fire. Amen. People get around you. I done told you. Peter's shadow, man. People that come across his shadow. That's what's going to start happening with you out in Walmart and Belk's and JCPenney. You still at JCPenney, Tammy? Get ready. That might be the next evangelistic association over at JCPenney. Amen. They start falling out right there at the counter, falling out. In Jesus' name. Underneath heel, waking up. Had a different kind of spirit, but that spirit gone now. Got God's spirit. Amen. No more of this, hey, Miss Tammy, how you doing? No. Delivered. Amen. Jesus said, he cast out the spirits with his word. A lot of times it's just you preaching the word, the spirit got to go. Amen. So a lot of people got these spirits. They don't know. I had spirits I didn't know had a hold on me. I didn't know. No, I was dumb to the spiritual realm until I got born again and I got hit with that anointing. But I had to get in there. I had to study. Man, I don't have to stay sick. I don't have to be in this credit card debt anymore. Because the Lord said, I'm your source. Amen. You don't have to pay these penalties. You don't have to pay this interest rate anymore. Amen. Get them things paid for and stay debt free. Amen. Hallelujah. It can happen with a miracle, or you can walk out. Walk out. Amen. Just keep walking. Just keep walking out. Don't look back. Don't be like Lot's wife. Don't look back. There's nothing back there for you. Once you walk out of darkness, don't you go back there. You keep your hand to the plow, Miss Tammy. You keep plowing that ground. Keep plowing the ground. Keep plowing, Jackie. People are hearing. They just haven't got the revelation's coming. So you're planting seeds, Terry. You're the seed planter. Somebody else is going to bring some water, and God's going to give some increase. I said, God's going to... The seed's going to bring forth after its kind. Amen. So you just keep planting the seed. Let God bring somebody else to water it. And then God's going to bring the increase. They're going to come and say, Terry or Wayne, pray with me. I need what you have. Amen. And they'll, boom, just like that. Bam. So Wednesday night, we're starting plans, purposes, and pursuits. And if you need a book, you want a book, you come let me know. I got a box over here. I will order more if we need to. Amen. Because we need to know God's plans. We need to know his purposes, and we need to be pursuing. David said, God told David, pursue and recover all. Amen. And we can get to see. The enemy didn't like David. Sometimes because of evil people, I've said this before, bad things happen to good people. But God will fight for us. Amen. It's not God's will. All those babies that died because they were looking, that the king Herod killed because he was looking for Jesus. God, it wasn't God's plan for any of those kids to die. It's the devil's plan. But God has a plan. God had a plan for Jesus. Joseph had to get up and do what the angel said. Or he would have had Jesus in jeopardy. Now I'm sure God would have did something. But Joseph, God gave him the dream. He didn't make Joseph do anything. But he chose Mary. God knows things that we don't know about people. Come on. There's things about people that we don't know that only God knows. There's no way they'll get saved. And then they turn around, man, they're on fire for Jesus. See, God knows people. He knows their pressure points. He knows those buttons to push. Amen. But he needs us. He needs us with our testimonies, with our duties, with those experiences that she has to go out there. See, God needs us. In these end times, he really needs us. Amen. He needs us to be declaring his truth. See, people have heard enough of the lies, the hypocrisies. They've got all these religious stuff. They're hungry for truth. Amen. And that's what we got to give them. We got to give them the truth. Don't water it down. Don't sugarcoat it. Give them the truth. Amen. And it'll set them free. If they want to be free, they can be set free. I tell you what, Jesus set me free. All it takes is one person in your family to change. To say, you know what, enough is enough. That's it. Be a pie for Jesus. That's all I can take, and I can't stand it no more. Give me that holy Bible. Amen. Give me that spinach. Bam. Dun, 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 dun. I know that's Rocky, but I'm trying to remember I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. Dun, dun, I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm good to the finish because I eat me spinach. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. Dun, dun. Hallelujah. There's none in this church that don't know that because I'm looking at the age group. Now, there's some, we might have to tell them a little bit of story, but you guys, except for Kelsey, have watched Popeye. I tell you what. Everything except for the tattoos, we all right? But don't even let tattoos persuade you that they can still love Jesus. Amen. Come on, don't get hung up on all this flesh. God's, all that stuff's going to be, it's going to be, God's going to give it back to them the way he planned it to begin with. It's all going to be burned up. We're going to get, that flesh is going to get glorified. Quit looking at the tattoos and look at the heart. Man, they had all kind of earrings and stuff when Jesus was out there preaching. He didn't miss a beat. He went out there, a sower sows the word. This is what the Father was saying. Tell him about the sower. Jesus says, a sower went out to sow. Amen. I just want to share that a little bit because I got a little bit of revelation on that this morning. The sower sows the word. Y'all help me. I think it's Matthew, ain't it? Matthew, Lord, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew. Help me, Kelsey. Sower sows the word. Give me it on the board. I won't even Google it. I got something better than Google. I got Kelsey Jackson. Amen. Matthew 13:3. Jesus spoke many things to the disciples, those that had ears to hear. I tell you what, multitudes followed Jesus, but multitudes stayed home. I tell you what, I'm going to be the one, I'm going to be in the multitude that's following Jesus. Amen. You got determined to be that. There's a lot of people through COVID, boy, I tell you what, we're just going to stay home and have our Lay's potato chips and have my vanilla iced coffee, and we're going to listen to Pastor Jackson online. You're going to miss something. I can't lay hands through that live stream TV. Jack can't put hands on you. You better get to church. What if they cut that live stream off? There's a lot of censoring going on out there too. Let me tell you something. They mute us on Facebook and I have to do some editing, but I tell you what, they can't mute the Holy Ghost. You come here, they can't censor God. Not live, amen, you can't do it. But I tell you what, people can still hear and not hear because they choose not to hear. A lot of things was because they've chose to hear so much other garbage. Jesus said, a sower went out to sow. He didn't say reed went out to sow. So he kept it universal. Amen. A sower went out to sow. And when he sowed, some of the seeds fell by the wayside. And the birds, the fowls, came up and devoured them up. You got any of them birds that you set something out, they did just devour it. Some fell upon stony places, seeds, and they didn't have much earth. Now, I talked about this. Hold that right there because I forgot about, I started something talking about Miss Sherri and I just totally forgot about her, didn't I? Talking about the kids retreat when we took the kids out. Well, she came back and she had an awesome teaching here talking about one person, and I was up back here trying to find things, so I missed a good bit of it. I had to go back and listen to it myself. But she was talking about the person that built their, had a foundation on sand, and she had some water up here, and she had some houses up here. She had a sand bucket, and she had some rocks and had some water in it, and she had a Reed could probably tell this better than I, because she had one house up here on the sand, and when she poured water in there, what happened to that house, Reed? That house just fell down. But then she had another house up here on the rocks, and when she poured water on that, what happened, Reed? That house stood. And see, that's what she's telling, Sherri's telling these kids a parable. She's showing them something that has a spiritual foundation in it, that in these end times, we're going to have good times. That when all these persecutions, when they say masks and lockdowns and you ain't going to have enough to eat and your gas, we're going to tell you how much gas to put in your car. I'm just saying things that's probably going to be said. We're going to listen to what the Word says. I got more than enough in my bank account, because my bank account is based on heaven, not what the government thinks they're going to do with my money, because it ain't my money, it's God's money. Hallelujah. I'm going to have more than enough to eat for my neighbors. I ain't going to have to get no gun and keep people out, because I'm going to feed the hungry. This is what's going to happen in the end times. Things are going to get dark, but not. We got a covenant with God, Randy. So we got our house, our foundation is built on Jesus Christ, the rock. And when all this stuff starts to happen, we got some seeds that's been planted. Our seeds didn't get ate up by the fowls of the air. Our seeds didn't get put on stony places and grew up and just withered away because they had no depthness of earth. There was another type of seed that said when the sun was up, they were scorched because they had no root and they withered away. But some seed fell among thorns and the thorns sprung up and choked them. But other fell, this is the word I like, fell into. See, all the other seeds fell on over here by the ground, on the rocks, by the wayside. These seeds went in somewhere. It says, but other seed fell into good ground. Into. That seed got into something. And if you let the Word of God get in your heart instead of on your heart, you'll have a bypass. You'll have a heart bypass. Amen. You'll get born again and you different. Because the seed brings forth after its kind. And that seed, when it gets into good ground, it brings forth fruit. Some, I like how he starts with 100-fold. Go ahead and start with 100, amen? Some 100, some 60, and some 30. I'm going to be the 100-fold, amen? I'm going to be the 100-watt light bulb for Jesus. I'm going to be so bright that people are going to see my Father and give him glory. That's what the seed, that's what God's seed will do if you let it get in your heart and keep getting in your heart, amen? And that's what Jesus talked about. And that's what we got to, that's why we're going to be preaching so hard. When I say hard, you're going to hear it and hear it and hear it. Amen. And Brenda's going to speak it from, see, Brenda had a word. She had that word. You guys are carrying the word. And the only reason I kind of had Brenda to share that, when I was back there in the back, the music was still kind of loud. And I don't think y'all heard Brenda, because I barely heard her. But she had a word from the Father. She spoke that word. Amen. Our Father hears. And our Father has all the power that we need. Amen. It doesn't drain heaven when we lay hands on the sick. It's not like the lights in heaven start to flicker. Oh gosh, they're using some of my power. No, there's never a dimness in heaven. We got all the power that we need to succeed down here on this earth. And there's all kind of different religions saying all different kind of things. See, there's a religion out there that says the earth is God. And you're going to destroy this earth by the way you're treating it. But my revelation is God created this earth to take care of me, not me to take care of the earth. So that's how you're going to know the difference between light and darkness. We got more than enough trees. We're going to have more than enough oxygen to survive. Amen. Amen. It's going to be hot and it's going to be cold. Get used to it. Because God said you're going to have summer, winter, you're going to have seasons. But I tell you, there's a season coming. There's another season coming. It's called the rapture. So when we leave, the temperature is going to rise. There are going to be all kinds of things hit this earth that can't hit it till we leave. So until we, as long as we occupying all this devastation, I know there's going to be hurricanes. Jesus said you're going to have wars, rumors of war. You're going to have famines. You're going to have all kinds of things in different places. But that's not the end. That's just the beginning of birth pains. But don't you be moved. Don't you be in fear. You look up, your redemption draws near. Amen. But you look up like Jesus to the Father, said, Father, we got people out here that need food. He looked up and blessed the food. So when you see these things, look up and say, Father, redemption's drawing near. Thank you, Lord. You've blessed me. Who you want me to go pray for right now, Lord? Who can I get saved before you come? See, we're not going to be in fear. We're going to be in faith. Amen. And when we see all those things, if we even see, we're going to see some of them, but not to the degree until we leave. Because the Antichrist, his system can't work till we leave. Come on. I'm not going to be worried about what I'm going to buy or sell because I've been marked. You've been marked with a mark. You don't have to have man to put it on you. It's in you. And the angels can see that mark in you. You've been marked by God, Randy. You've been marked, Tammy. So we're not worrying about the devil's mark. It's going to be put on people. I've already been marked. Amen. I've been counted worthy because of the blood of the Lamb. Amen. And just like I performed a wedding ceremony yesterday, I gave this beautiful bride to her husband. And I spoke a blessing over that union. You're going to be blessed. I even took out through sickness and in health. I don't even want to preach yet. I just want the blessing. I just want you to know you're going to be in health. I didn't say that, but I take that out of wedding ceremonies. Because God didn't put it in his when he joined Adam and Eve. There was no sickness. Why should I add it? Why should I be expecting it? Amen. Why do I want them to expect? I want you to expect the blessing. Amen. So I am not expecting the bride of Christ to go through hell on this earth, because that's not the way Jesus would treat his bride. So don't be deceived by the devil or by religious people from the pulpit telling you that God's going to judge you. God's already judged Jesus. And I'm not going to be judged. You're not going to be judged. You're not going to hear that preached from this pulpit, because Jesus was judged so that we could be free. Amen. A spotless church without spot or wrinkle. Amen. Because we done been through the fire. You put clothes in the dryer to de-wrinkle them. We done been through the fire through Jesus. Amen. He got in the fire with us. The Holy Ghost fire. We're a glorious church. Amen. And we're expecting a glorious departure, but we got to take some with us. Amen. There's a lot of people out there that still need to know Jesus. And we are vessels to take that message to them. Amen. Amen. To take it to the streets, to Walmart, Kmart. You're wearing it, the T-shirt ministry. I'm seeing green, orange, blue. But people are looking, they're reading. They're looking for hope out there. That's going to lead people to this church. Keep wearing your T-shirts, but be ready to give the testimony of the hope that you have. Amen. You need to come hear the message. Amen. Because when Jesus calls us home, I'm leaving this T-shirt behind. Amen. Because he's going to clothe me with a robe of righteousness. He's going to put another robe on me. Amen. What a glorious day that's going to be. But you're already clothed in it. It's a spiritual robe. The devil knows. The devil sees you. But he can't stop you. He wishes he could. But he's got to have your voice. He's just like Barney Fife. You just got to give him the bullet if you want to be defeated. See, if you give the devil fear, he'll defeat you. He'll shoot you in the foot with it. He'll take your whole family out if you keep giving him fear. That's right. But when you give him the unadulterated word of God, spoken by the Holy Ghost, he's got to leave, Jack. And don't come back, Jack. Keep him out the back. Mm-mm-mm. God's good. All the time. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I just speak blessings over your people today, Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you, Father God, for the end time harvest across this world, in this community, in Concord, Cabarrus County. Father, we speak blessings over our kids at school, Father. Thank you, Lord, for watching over JR. Lord, I know he took a bruise to the eye, but thank you, Lord, for protecting him. Kids are going to be kids. They're going to do some stupid things, but thank you, Lord, for loving stupid kids, keeping us safe, Lord. Even when we do stupid things, Lord, you watch over and protect us. We thank you, Lord, for touching JR's eye. We thank you, Lord, for raising Frankie up, Father. I thank you, Lord, for the body ministering to him. And we thank you, Lord, for the Holy Ghost helping him reap that pain leaving his knee in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for getting him up and getting him moving, Father. We thank you for the foundation, the word he's heard, Lord, is in his heart, Lord. We just thank you right now it comes out of his mouth, and Lord, he gets up and does what he says he can do. I can do all things. I can do all things with this new knee without pain, thank you, Lord, for the surgery, but thank you, Father God, that you are the lifter of my soul. Lord, you get me up and get me moving. That, Lord, even when we get older, Lord, we'll bring forth fruit, have strength in our old age. We just give you the praise for that, Lord. Thank you for that, Father. Thank you, Lord. I just speak blessings over your people today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord, for in these end times, you said we can have good times. We can see, we can destroy principalities and powers, Lord. We can see hope, not in the distance. We're carrying it. That people see us, they see hope. Father, I thank you, Lord, as your people leave this place, Lord, just their shadow. Lord, people get healed when your people walk by. People that are sick get healed. People that are in fear, Lord, get set free by faith, by the spirit of faith that we're carrying, Lord. And we thank you, Holy Ghost, for empowering us for this hour to be on fire for Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father God, for good reports that we get. Lord, we speak bad reports. We call them to be good reports. No matter what we face, Lord, we thank you we don't face it alone. It's by your mighty working power. You said we can leap and jump over obstacles that the devil would try to put in our way. We thank you for that. We speak blessings to Hope Church, Father. I thank you, Lord, for the work you've called Scott and Shirlene, and we thank you, Father God, that we are partners with them with the vision, Father. Thank you, Lord, for raising Scott's hands up, Lord, holding his hands up, Lord, just like Moses, his hands was held up, and they were as long as his hand was in the air, they was winning the battle. And Lord, we're here to hold his hands up, hold that vision up of Hope Church. If there's people in Matthews, in that area, Father God, that need to hear the good word, need to be built up in hope and faith. We thank you, Father God, for sending them people, all the audio, video people they need, the ministry teams that they need, to get the work done that needs to be done in that area. And we thank you for that, Father. In Jesus' name, can you say amen? Anybody need personal prayer this morning? Thank you, Jesus.
I wonder if we lift us up. We're leaving, I think, Thursday to go to Houston.
Houston.
So, traveling prayers.
With a capital T. Houston, Texas, right? Yep. Hallelujah. What do you see, Terry?
I see healing at the other end.
Amen. Texas is a big place. There's an evangelist called Jonathan Shuttlesworth is opening up his second church. He didn't even got his first church building. He started out with one. He thought it was a church. That wasn't it. He had to have something bigger. His first Sunday service, he expecting 40 to 50 people, had 400 people in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania show up, coming from all kind of places. Now he's opened up a church in Fort Dobbs, Texas. I'm pretty sure it's Fort Dobbs. There's people in Texas that need Jesus. That need Jesus. God's doing a big work in these days, these last days, and it's fast. He was saying it before he told his wife. He did say it. I mean, but God spoke it to him, and he was saying it, and then he got with his wife. As soon as it hit him, Randy, God hit him with the vision. He spoke it out of his mouth. It's coming to pass. He already had like 400 people, volunteers, show up, and they're opening. They're starting that church in September. No, October. Ain't even got the first one done. God says, start another one. Because the time is short. Time is short. Amen? I just believe the Lord showed me people are running in the Spirit. They're going to find this place. This is one of the places they're going to find hope. They're going to find refuge. So, Father, I thank you, Lord, as Terry goes to Texas, Lord, there's people that need hope out there in Texas. Lord, where he's going, a lot of times we see places we're going as like a vacation, a time of rest, but, Lord, it's opportunities, Terry. There's opportunities out there. Just be ready to share the hope that you have in Houston, in Jesus' name. And enjoy yourself. God wants us to enjoy ourselves. Just carry him with us wherever we go. Yes.
Let's see, one thing else. You were talking about heating, cooling. You know, it's going to be hot and cold.
Thank you for joining us today at Word of Faith Worship Center. I pray God's grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if you do not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then according to Romans 10, 8 through 10, the word is nigh unto thee, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach, that if you will confess with your mouth Jesus as your Lord and believe that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart you believe unto righteousness, and with your mouth confession is made unto salvation. We would ask you today to simply say, yes, I believe this, and I say yes to Jesus. Now, if you just received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we would encourage you to get into a good church. Our church is located at 757 Harris Street, Northwest, Concord, North Carolina, 28025. And you can also find us on the internet at wordoffaithworshipcenter.org or wofwc.org. We hope to see you soon. Blessings.